Assalamu alaikum student, how are you all? So today the remaining topics of the chapter is force and kinetic theory. As you all know that what is kinetic theory? I told you that kinetic theory is simply that in a substance kinetic energy is so high that the substance will change its state from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas. So this is the force and kinetic theory, and these are the points. Number one is gas molecules have large kinetic energy. Why? Gas molecules have large kinetic energy, but why? Because they have so many gap in between them. So that's why they have a larger kinetic theory as compared to other states like solid and liquid. Solid have too small amount of gap between its substances, so that's why it got the extreme lowest kinetic energy or kinetic theory. Plus see, whenever a substance or a molecule contain kinetic energy at the lowest point, it means that the motion of that substance is too slow, so that's why it got least kinetic energy, just because of its movement. And there is no gap between solid, so that's why they form only vibratory motion, two and four motion, so that's why their kinetic energy is too low. And For the second state of the matter, which is liquid, they contain some amount of gap between the molecule. For example, this amount of gap. So they form a linear motion. They perform a linear motion. So that's why they have the less amount of kinetic energy, less than solid, but less than gas and more than solid, because they have slightly bit more gap as compared to solid. So that's why they have more kinetic energy as compared to solid. Now, if the kinetic energy of gas are extremely high or large, it means that the melting point and the boiling point of that compound will be the lowest point. Why? Because of the kinetic energy which is belong to that compound. So that's why their boiling point and their melting points are too low. And the second one is liquid molecule, because they got less kinetic energy as compared to gas. So that contain a comparatively high melting and boiling point as compared to gas, because they are moving but still they are connected within the position. So that's why they are comparatively high melting and boiling point. The third one is solid molecules, they got extreme lowest kinetic energy just because of their composition and their fixed position. So that's why they got the extreme lowest kinetic energy. So their melting point and boiling point will be high as compared to gas, liquid. The solid melting point and boiling point will be high, extremely high, because of their position, their fixed position. So these are the main point of force and kinetic theory. Whenever a solid become liquid just because of the kinetic theory. For example, if we melt an ice, okay, if we melt an ice, so it will become a liquid, a water. Why? Just because we are giving it a heat. Through the heat, the molecule of solid particle will start moving. So that will bring the force and the the kinetic theory will be act on that solid, so the solid can become converted into liquid. Okay, this is the chart number 1 and chart number 2. The first chart is showing that how a solid is becoming a liquid and a liquid is becoming a gas. So for an example, if the solid is getting an extra amount of heat, which means extra kinetic energy. Okay, whenever a solid will gain an extra amount of kinetic energy, it means that the particle of solid will start moving fastly. So because of that movement, the bond between the solid particle will break. So that's why they become liquid. From solid they become liquid and they become melt. So that point is known as melting point. After that, if we are still giving some heat to that particle, to that liquid, so the liquid will also start moving more fastly. So then the liquid become further gas, and that point will be the boiling point. Okay, so these are the three states and these are the three properties. Solid on heating become liquid, and liquid on melting they become gas from boiling. Okay, so the second chart is the reverse of that chart is this, that how a gas particle will become a liquid particle again. Now how? It is the reverse particle of exothermic. It will become now endothermic process. Why? Because on escaping the excess amount of kinetic energy, the gas will convert itself from gas to liquid. On cooling, a gas becomes a liquid, and on condensation, a liquid becomes solid. Okay, so for example, if we are putting water in a bottle and we are placing the bottle into the freezer, on freezer the liquid become freeze because of its slow amount of kinetic energy, because there is no space to run, and so that's why the liquid will become further solid. Okay, so this is the chart: three state, gas, liquid, solid, and three properties: cooling, condensation, and freezing. So from that, a gas will convert into liquid, a liquid will be converting into solid, and these are the extra points of this theory. Number one, helium has lowest boiling and melting point. And magnesium is the only metal that is not solid at room temperature, which means that itself, magnesium is a liquid. But magnesium is a metal, a metallic liquid. So it is the only metal in the world which is not solid at room temperature, just because of kinetic theory and the kinetic energy that the magnesium carries, that the mercury contains itself. And the first point is helium has the lowest boiling and melting point, because helium is the gas. Helium is present in the world as a gas. So, as I told you that because of this large kinetic energy, they got low melting and boiling point. So that's why helium is a gas. It will contain low melting and boiling point. And in the second hand, mercury, which is mean Hg, is the symbol of mercury. Mercury is the only metal liquid which is present in the world as a liquid form in the room temperature just because of its kinetic energy. Okay class, so the second topic of this chapter is gases and kinetic theory. Before this topic, we studied about the properties and the kinetic theory. Okay, so in this chapter, we are studying the gas, the matter which belongs the most to gases. So, the gases and the kinetic theory. As you all know that what is a gas? Gas is the form of a matter which have not definite shape, not the volume. Okay, so these are the behavior of gases during kinetic energy according to the kinetic theory. So, number one is large distance between them. The gas particle have large distance between them. Okay. Number second is they collide in change direction. See, whenever a gas is present into a container, so the gas will flow. It move randomly. It will move randomly. So whenever the gas particle will move, so it will collide with another gas particle or with the wall of that container. Okay, and gas also have the higher amount of kinetic energy because of the large distance between them. Because of the collision, motion is random and constant. Gases are moving randomly and they are moving constantly because they are in motion throughout their life. Okay, so this is the first property of gas because of this kinetic theory. The first property is pressure. That you all know that what is pressure? Pressure means force per unit area. A force which is obtained or being forced on a per unit area, that is pressure. So, gas has some pressure. Number one is exert pressure when they collide with wall. When the gas particle collide with the container wall, so it will exert an amount of pressure because it exerting a force per unit area. Okay, so it will the number of molecule increases, so the collision will also increases in number because there will be number of molecule who are becoming hit by the wall, just like it is shown in the diagram. In this diagram, the particle of gases are too small. Okay, so that's why the pressure is also small. In this diagram, there are higher number of gas particles, so that's why the increase. So that's why the pressure is becoming greater in this diagram. Okay, so it means that higher the number of gas molecules, so the pressure will be higher because of the collision between the container wall and the gas particle. So after that, the higher the collision, higher will be the pressure. For example, blowing the balloon. For example, if we blow a balloon with a pump, so higher will be the blowing, so the pressure of the gas will become higher. And the second one is compression. Whenever we compress a container filled with gas, so the pressure will become higher because of the compression. Because we are compressing the volume, so that's why the pressure is becoming double. The second behavior is the volume. Do you know what is volume? Volume is the space occupied by a matter. So gas is a matter. Okay, so volume is shown by the meter cubic. Cubic meter is the formula of volume. So gas has no definite volume because of their large distance. Okay, the second one is volume of gases increases by decreasing the pressure. As I told you that whenever we compress the container, that contain amount of gases, so the compression will be higher, which means the pressure will become extra. It will become higher. Okay, so the volume will be decreased and the pressure will be increases. And so that is the example of diffusion of perfume. Whenever we spray something, because the perfume is in gas form, so whenever we spray that, so it will diffuse throughout the room just because of the higher volume. Okay, the last one is temperature. Temperature is the last behavior of the gases in this chapter. So what is temperature? Temperature is the hotness and coldness of a body. Okay, so average kinetic energy, which means that whenever a gas contains higher kinetic energy, it will contain a certain amount of temperature. Okay, so the first point is, when we heat up a gas, it means that the temperature will be increases, and when we cool the gas, it means that the temperature will be decreases. So that is the last behavior of gas of, according to the kinetic theory. Okay class, so the last topic of this chapter is pressure and volume relationship. There was a scientist whose name was Robert Weil. He was a physicist and a chemist. At the time of 1662, he discovered a law, a relationship of the gas between pressure and the volume of the gas. Okay, so he told us that he introduced the law that which is known as the Weil's law. Okay, so the statement of this law is, the volume of a fixed mass of a gas is inversely proportional to the pressure provided its temperature remains constant. Whenever we exert a certain amount of a pressure or a container of gas, so the volume become decreases because of the increase in the pressure. This is known as the Boyle's law in a constant temperature. Okay, if the temperature is constant, whenever the pressure of the gas increases, so it will decrease the volume of the gas. It is known as the Boyle's law. The second point, okay, so the formula of this law is P is inversely proportional to the V. P means pressure, V means volume, and vice versa, V is inversely proportional to the P, which means volume is inversely proportional to the pressure of the gas at the constant temperature. So the graph of this law will be like this. It will be an inclined graph, because whenever the pressure increases, so the volume will be decreases, and whenever the volume increases, so the pressure will be decreases. Okay, the third point is, on constant temperature, when the temperature remains constant, so we take the formula as PV is equal to constant, which means the product of the pressure and the volume of the gas will be constant. And after that, so the equation will be P1V1 is equal to P2V2, which means the pressure and volume of the experiment is equal to constant, or is equal to the pressure and volume before the experiment and after the experiment will be the same because of the constant temperature. Okay, and so the graph will be like scale just because of the constant temperature. And the last is the example that where the Boyle's law is applicable. So we are applying it in the international platform, because we are applying this law in spray paint. In this book, you see this, it is the picture, this one. So these are the examples of application of Boyle's law. Okay, so class, this is a problem in a book. So the numerical values of these are, this part is the data. Pressure number 1, which means pressure of the gas before the experiment. Okay, so the pressure number one value is 140 kilopascal. Pascal is the unit of pressure. Number two, the second data is volume number one is equal to 60 centimeter cubic. Okay, so the volume is in centimeter, so that's why it is centimeter cubic. And after the experiment, the pressure is increases, so the new value is 420 kilopascal, the new pressure. The remaining data which we have to find is volume number 2, that's the question mark. So this is the formula, V1 is equal to P2 V2. So this is the formula we get from the Boyle's law. Okay, so we have to rearrange this formula for the sake of solving this question. So it will be V2 is equal to P1 multiplied by V1. So it will be divided with P2. Okay, so that's why the P2 will be divided by the V2. So when we put the data in this question, so we get 140 multiplied by 60 divided by 420. So by calculating them, we get 20. 20 is the new volume of that gas after the pressure increases. So the volume decreases. It shows that Boyle's law is applicable, which that means whenever the pressure increases of the gas, the volume of the gas will decrease at the same rate. Okay, so this is the last part of this chapter. So this chapter is closed. Inshallah, we will be doing the question answer of this chapter. Okay, class, Allah Hafiz.